Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. Let's go ahead and talk about some gameplay for Zen Meteor. I say gameplay. Sadly, not that much. As usual with things like this, we tend to get a very limited amount before release, but we do have gameplay of a kind, and it does demonstrate the key perk of Zen Meteor quite sufficiently. For those of you who don't know, Zen Meteor is a PlayStation-exclusive exotic weapon that is coming with the April update, and it's a sniper rifle, which is quite some cause for excitement. So, with Zen Meteor, what is the set of perks that you'll be able to get, and why the hell is it lighting on fire? Well, it's lighting on fire primarily because of the Dynamite perk. Now, this is a perk that comes on the weapon automatically. It is intrinsic to it. You don't need to unlock anything or level it in order to get this perk. But Dynamite has some very interesting effects. So first of all, it's going to grant explosive rounds. For those of you who don't know what that perk does, essentially the damage is split in two. The first half is dealt as normal directly to the target, and the second half is dealt to both the target and any other surrounding targets in the area. So definitely an interesting perk to have on a sniper because you can deal lots of damage to large groups of enemies. On top of that, rapid kills with every round in the clip load an extra higher damage round for 5 seconds. This is what really interests me, because we're going to be able to sit here and potentially clear large groups of PvE mobs with this sniper. Keep in mind that whilst that round is only going to stay in your clip for 5 seconds, it is still a more damaging round, so that means explosive rounds is probably going to do more damage as well. Exciting prospect, you can kill all of the acolytes surrounding a knight and then take the knight out potentially with this as well. There's just lots of potential for crowd control with this weapon, and I don't know how good that's going to be just because you can do that with practically any weapon, but this is going to be very efficient. So I wonder whether this will have some kind of very niche use. However, the next perk that goes in with Dynamite is really exciting, and that perk is with a laser beam. Yeah, sounds awesome, and it is pretty awesome too. So with a laser beam basically means that the extra round that you get with Dynamite will cause a massive explosion. That's just so much fun. I kind of love that. But the wonderful thing about that, of course, is if you didn't have enough crowd control in the first place, now you can just blow up a bunch of dudes. So I just like this sniper. I don't know, this is looking fun. I love the idea of just killing three people and there's a thrall left, and then just blowing up the thrall. Like, that to me speaks volumes of fun. But yeah, no, those are the perks you're going to be able to get on this sniper rifle, which make a real difference. The other ones which are not as effective are going to be as follows. For your ballistic options, you've got CQB ballistics, soft ballistics, and smart drift control. Next up, in your middle column, you've got Underdog. Now, for those of you who don't remember, Underdog basically means that when you've taken critical damage, your range and handling increases. So, range is not going to be too significant a factor with this sniper, but I'd expect that handling is going to be the one of those that makes a difference. Is Underdog a good perk? Not really, no. Your final column of perks is going to include Fitted Stock, Field Scout, and Injection Mold. Now, it sounds like a very obvious choice there to at first go for injection mold, but given the amount of ammunition with this, it might be a similar case to Snapshot on the Chaperone. Field Scout may not be a bad option just because sniper rifles did get their ammo reserves nerfed quite hard, and Field Scout is going to maximize the ammo reserve once again, and that's going to really help you out, especially seeing as there are only 3 rounds in this clip. If you want to consistently be efficiently clearing mobs, it may actually be the correct choice in PvE. However, if you're going into PvP, I would recommend taking injection mold for the simple increases in both stability and handling speed. There's really not much more I can say there, it's as simple as that. The perks on this weapon become even more remarkable when you realize that for the scopes, or at least for the ballistic options rather, you have smart drift control in there, which is a very unusual choice for a sniper rifle. I've almost never seen it on any weapon. So picking this up in the first place is kind of rare, but then you have to consider the fact that with this particular weapon, you get a lot of stability with a perk like that. So pairing that with injection mold, for example, might actually be an amazing way of dampening down the recoil and making this a very good PvP sniper. However, I don't know how good it's going to be in comparison to others, because of course you then have to take into account how viable Underdog, Dynamite, and with a laser beam is really going to be in PvP. I have no idea how viable it will be, but, you know, there's some interesting stuff that could be done. I mean, it's sort of viable in trials. You've got 3 rounds there, so if you don't miss, you're going to be good. I don't know. We'll have to see with this one. But basically, go ahead, jump in, see if you can get yourself the Zen Meteor in the April update, because it looks like, aside from anything else, it's just going to be a really fun weapon. In addition to that, we got some cool goodies that we'll be able to get from the PlayStation exclusive quest, and for those of you who are on PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 3, you're going to be able to get some new armor from those Sublime Engrams that have been dropping. So, first of all, the Sparrow, you get it from completing the quest, which mainly takes you through the Court of Oryx, and it's called the Velumbra Sparrow. Velumbra. It's a very interesting little kind of blue, yellow, and white color mix. I don't know how to best put that, but, you know, goes with the theme of the new armor as well. I know that personally I'm looking actually to get the Hunter armor of this, just because the jacket reminds me of Star Wars. Specifically, I mean, I'm just gonna throw some images up there. Everyone in Hoth rocks a jacket like this. You throw Shadowite on that, you have a Hoth shader. So, I mean, I think my Hunter is due for some changes, because I was never really quite satisfied with the armor that I had on it. So I'm probably going to be picking myself up that jacket. I don't know about the helmet, I'll probably stick with something different, but it's exciting stuff, at very least, to see some new armor out there on the table for PlayStation players. I know, I'm sorry, Xbox players. You sadly don't get this armor. And it really sucks because the Titan's Jovian Guard is also really awesome. You get Zavala's shoulder plate. You get the damn massive shoulder plate. That's pretty cool. And the Warlock armor looks like Jedi robes as usual. So, you know, there's good stuff here. And I cannot help but feel that some of it is very referential of Star Wars, at least in its theme. So, you know, cool stuff for that particular thing. And of course, you can get these from Sublime Engrams. The Sparrow comes from Petra Venge's PlayStation exclusive quest. And again, Zen Meteor, you just have to roll your luck with the exotic engrams there, friends. In the meantime though, guys, thank you so much for watching. Apologies that I couldn't get the lore video out to you today. I've been buried in my real life work and, you know, for the next month I may be on and off just a tiny bit, but fear not, because the end is in sight, and when the end does come, I will finally be able to do YouTube full time. Exciting prospect, really exciting prospect, and I want to be able to go ahead and ramp up the video production on every single front. More lore, more of these news videos on a more consistent and a higher quality basis. We're going to be able to get more cool projects out there to you guys and maybe able to stream a bit. There's a ton of stuff that I'm really looking forward to doing this summer, and I can't wait to share all of it with you guys. So, in the meantime, my name is Bife. Por Audacia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.